You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Monday, May 4th, 2020. This month on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are going to be honoring our mother, Mary. Each week, we are going to be looking at a different time when Mary appeared to her followers, the message that she had, the incredible motherly way that she spoke to these people, and then the incredible impact that these apparitions have had. This week, we are going to kick things off with one of my favorite stories, which is Juan Diego and Our Lady of Guadalupe. But before we get there, I just want to spend 1 minute reminding you why Mary is so important. Now, the month of May is dedicated to Mary, our mother, and the church does this because she is so important. Many saints have said that the easiest way to get to heaven is through Mary. Mary is our loving mother, and she doesn't want anything for herself. She is the first, the original disciple, and it is her mission to bring us to her son. We can never love Mary more than Jesus loved her. That's what St. Maximilian Kolbe told us, and it's so true. So every step you take closer to Mary, every Hail Mary you say, every time you learn about a Marian apparition, you're really moving closer to Jesus. So today, let's kick things off by talking about Our Lady of Guadalupe. Now, we are going to talk about this apparition all week long. Today, I want to talk about what Mexico, or the land area that became the country of Mexico, where Our Lady of Guadalupe appeared, but what it was like before she appeared there. Now, just maybe 10 or so years before she appeared, missionaries began to arrive from Spain. Now, all of the European countries were sending out explorers to what they called the New World. They arrived, and often through violent and horrible means, they conquered the native people and took over. Before the Spanish people arrived, the Aztecs were the dominant tribe in the area. Now, the Aztecs were brutal, they were violent, and they were pagan. Pagan meaning that they worshipped many gods. But the gods that the Aztecs worshipped were horrible, and they demanded human sacrifices. We can see from history that some years, the human sacrifices got so out of control with the Aztec tribe that almost 50,000 people would be killed to appease these gods. When the Spanish people arrived, they were appalled to see how violent these tribes were. And after they conquered the tribes that existed in the area, there was a really tense relationship. Even the Spanish missionaries were a little hesitant to evangelize the Aztecs because they remembered how violent they had been. And so as a result, many of the misled Spanish that arrived enslaved the native people and treated them horribly. Very few of the native people were converted to the Catholic faith. And one of these people that did convert was Juan Diego and his wife. Now, Juan Diego was a poor Indian man. He had no children. And yet he, for some reason, had really been moved by the message of the missionaries, and he had converted. And this is the poor peasant man that Mary chose to appear to. She appeared to him in the middle of the desert, and Juan Diego made a practice of walking every day to go to Mass or to go to religious education as he was still learning the faith. And it was on this path, as he walked to the church, that Mary met him. Now, we're going to get into her meeting, the amazing way that she spoke to Juan Diego tomorrow. But first, my friends, I would like you to pray for something that Mary really did accomplish when she appeared to Juan Diego. I want you to pray for unity between people of different faiths. Now, we know that as Catholics, we have the fullness of faith, but we also know that we never have a right to hate or mistreat other people, even if they believe other things, that we should always treat them with love. And it is, of course, through love that people will become open to our faith and open to believing that we do have the fullness of truth. So please, my friends, pray for unity between faiths, especially faiths where there is a history of violence.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Welcome to May, my friends. To celebrate the month of Mary, we are offering our rosary materials at as accessible a price as we can. We're offering the rosary booklets for adults at half off, and we've also discounted our board book rosary set, just in the hope that Mary can really be a comfort for you as we continue these days of isolation and uncertainty. You can check out both of these products or also start earning your own rosary patch by committing it to pray to the rosary for 30 days in a row. Information on both of these things can be found in links that are included in the notes for this episode.